Huh? I got it. Ho ho! Yes! What?
Whoa!
Mario?
Luigi, you saved Mario.
I did it.
Way to go. Oh. Number one.
Ororo, Udo, Pam Pam.
Of course, a Luigi's Mansion game would not be complete without the King Boo boss fight. And oddly enough, the person to ultimately blame for this whole game happening is Egad of all people. Well, either that or one of Egad's neighbors, because in the stupid throwaway line, it turns out that Egad decided it was a brilliant idea to sell the portrait of King Boo from the original game at a garage sale. And then wonders how King Boo managed to escape after that, and considering that in this game, he's using ghost-proof vacuum jail cells to hold all the ghosts and boos, that's actually a really stupid move, Mr. Gad. Way to go. And to finish it up, we got this really gimmicky final boss fight with our friend Tasmal Foe. Immediately after the Knightmare boss fight, and picking up the final Dark Moon Shard, King Boo has decided to throw off the gloves and basically abducted Luigi for a revenge fight in an alternate dimension where he holds all the cards. The ironic thing is that even in this case, King Boo still manages to lose. Next level was taking notes from the original game, and it seems like King Boo still retains his weakness to spiked balls, which Luigi has to lure the King Boo into so that they smack him in the head, and he can attempt to capture the King Boo, who, unlike the ghost dog from previous parts of the game, cannot escape the poltergust on his own whims, despite his massive power-up from destroying the Dark Moon. The major problem with the fight is that the puzzle to beat King Boo is not obvious, and can lead to a lot of pointless running around and trial and erroring before the fight can actually get started, because the game doesn't show that the spike balls falling from the sky can actually hurt King Boo. It seems more obvious that trying to get the spike balls to run into King Boo on the ground would be the way, but nope. King Boo is stunned by shining the flashlight at him, and he can be stunned for like 15 seconds. So the only strategy to this is to act as a lure and lead King Boo into the spike ball shadows and then catch him. He doesn't have a ton of health like the original game, so that's pretty easy. But that doesn't mean King Boo doesn't have some new tricks. After he releases himself from the vacuum with his crown getting stuck, he flings Luigi into a created mansion and chases him through a 2D furniture dodging minigame, which is mostly in the fight to allow the player to get back some health and free cash. The game gives you massive health buybacks at the ends of these stages, so just managing to live through them will get you into a good spot to continue defeating the king. The next two phases are essentially the same, and King Boo might pull out a couple new attacks, like the screen-spanning lightning strikes and adding ice on the floor. But the essential spiked ball to the face concept is the same, and he retains the same health bar. This boss fight is going to be a marathon, since it's three phases long and the overloaded attack repertoire and gimmickiness of King Boo himself doesn't make this ending super satisfying for this overall great title. Mostly because the final boss fight and ending is really abrupt. There is literally no drink of water between Knightmare and King Boo, and I would have done them in one video, except I felt that the two bosses were so different from each other that there wasn't enough connecting the two to really justify a single video. Plus, the two of them are of significantly different qualities. I mean, sure, this is good, but it's not that good. Hell, King Boo was barely in the game this entire time, letting his cronies do all the work for him. I don't know. I just expected more from this guy.